The shrink film will be installed in multiple sections using the various roll sizes available through Protect Plastics and Supply Incorporated. There are two distinct methods used to connect the sections of shrink film together. Although you will choose a primary method, on most projects you'll need to use a combination of the two techniques depending upon the circumstances. The first technique is the wood seaming method. This is the most secure way to apply heat shrink film and is also more labor intensive. When using this technique, the shrink film's bottom, top, and sides are rolled around a 1x2 or 1x4 wood lathe strip and securely fastened, usually with a nail gun, to the 2x4 nailer secured onto the scaffold framework. The wood seaming method is the preferred method for circumstances where the shrink film may need to withstand inclement weather or will be in place over long periods of time. If you decide to use the wood seaming method, you may still need to apply the heat seaming method to hard-to-reach or odd-shaped areas. Your second option is to use the heat seaming method. When using this technique, the overlapped ends of the shrink film are tacked together using Protex spray adhesive, then sealed with the heat tool and reinforced with heat shrink tape. The heat seaming method is sufficient for normal conditions where severe weather or long duty cycles are not expected. It is usually quicker and more economical to use this technique. When using the heat seaming method, you will still need to use the wood seaming method for anchoring the top and bottom perimeter of your containment. When you are not containing all sides of the structure, for instance, when containing a single wall, you will also need to wood seam the sides for full structural integrity.